Hi, Sheri. Thanks for coming to share your story with us.
You're welcome.
Would you like to start off telling us a little bit about yourself, perhaps a bit about your involvement with Through the Roof?
Yes, of course. Okay, well, hello everyone who's listening. My name is Sheri Cavill, and I live in Ingatestone in Essex with my husband, John. And I've recently become the Roofbreaker champion for the Ealing Pentecostal Church here in the village. I've been a Christian since 1979 when I gave my life to the Lord, and I was baptized in 1980. When I was 9 months old, I was diagnosed with oculocutaneous albinism, which is a genetic defect which affects the construction of the eyes. So albinos have very pale skin, very pale hair colouring, and depending on an enzyme called tyrosinase, we can either have blue eyes or pink. So I have got blue eyes, and I've been registered blind since birth, although I do have about 5% of normal sight with complications. So it's been interesting. I truly believe for myself that God created me the way I am. I think because I was born like this, and the word says we're fearfully and wonderfully made, and we're created in our mother's womb.
Yeah.
And I feel that I was created this way. I'm not a mistake. God didn't make a mistake. And I've always been very pleased with the way I am. Sometimes people look at me a bit askance, but I say, well, when did the clay ever argue with the potter, you know? So I'm totally satisfied with myself. It's had a number of challenges all my life, really. So my challenges in the world, to some degree, have been the same as my challenges in my faith and in the church. It's never affected my faith, because I believe God made me this way. It's part of my God-given individuality, and it's never had any impact on my faith at all.
That's really a gift for everyone to hear that perspective. And do you go to church, Sheri?
Yes, we attend church regularly here in the village every Sunday. I belong to a prayer group, and we belong to a house group. So before lockdown, we were fully involved in various church activities.
Does your sight does that affect how you might serve at church?
I think so, yes, because I wouldn't feel comfortable working with children, because I really haven't got the sight to handle that kind of work. So I would be a bit restricted in that way. Over the years, things have not really been sort of geared towards blind people and people with sight loss. So there have been some challenges in the church in what I would perhaps have liked to have done. But I play drums in the worship group.
Maybe next time you can do a demonstration for us.
Oh, I'd love to. But I take part in most things, and we're very blessed. Our minister is lovely. He's very much on board with making the church comfortable for people like myself and others.
Yeah, it sounds like you feel really like you belong at the church, and that they've probably learned a lot as well, would you say, about including everybody. Would you like to share a key message for the church at the moment?
I think the message for disabled people is to be encouraged to keep going and to keep sharing ourselves with people in church. I'd like, for me, from a Roofbreaker point of view, my main aim is to change attitudes towards people like ourselves. That's one of the biggest challenges I've had in the past, where people haven't understood, and things have been difficult at times. So I want to sort of, the message I want to send to the church is, you know, here we are people. We have as many talents as others do, but in different ways.
Absolutely.
We may not be physically very mobile, but we can still do things. Disability doesn't mean inability. To try to change those attitudes to make people more understanding and more relaxed around us, because not everybody likes to be around blind people. That's something you learn. And I want to sort of promote good relationships and good attitudes in the church towards ourselves, and also from ourselves, because it can be sometimes we have a little bit of attitude as well as disabled people because of hurts and problems in our lives. And we're perhaps not always as relaxed and helpful around other people. So it's a two-way thing, isn't it?
Absolutely. And I think that's really important. Yes, that it is a two-way thing. And I think disabled people as well, they can learn a lot from each other on how to have perhaps more grace and understanding for people who don't experience life with extra challenges, perhaps.
That's right. Yes, I mean, the average person doesn't meet blind people every day. I'm talking from my own point of view, but the average person doesn't meet us every day. And we, you know, something you're they're confronted with you and they just don't know quite how to act, you know. And that can bring forth a myriad of emotions from the other person and from yourself as well.
Yes. So,
yeah. But to the message to disabled people from me would be to keep going and, yeah.
Yes, thank you so much, Sheri.